on, Rob. We talked about 22 counties. Wind is the issue and the time frame. When would you expect? I mean, we're looking at what? Tomorrow is 95 degrees or something is like an amazing cool down considering where we've been. Where are we going to get some relief from wind and heat?
We're going to get relief from wind and from heat tomorrow. Now, it's going to first be toward the coastal hills area, that red flag warning for fire conditions, which is happening right now all the way through tonight. That should expire and go away at 8 o'clock in the morning because the humidity will have come up enough, the wind will come down enough, and the temperature starting to cool. Now, for the valley and also for the Sierra, it looks more likely till about noon or so tomorrow. So this is not the longest lasting red flag warning, but remember, they all matter, they're all important, and we've seen fires break out in red flag conditions that grow quickly, and you need to take every single one of them seriously. This is the area for this current one. This is the foothills of the coastal range. This is the valley floor, and this is all of the Sierra. This, by the way, goes into Oregon and Washington, which early this morning, those two states have seen some major fires break out, and we just don't want to be part of that. The next thing I'm going to show you is the wind forecast for today, because it will be changing, of course, hour by hour, and it all matters what's happening in your neighborhood, so you can plan for it. The strongest winds at the moment are in the coastal range, out towards Santa Rosa and some of those foothills, and also some canyons, passes, and ridgetops in the Sierra. Now, when you look at the actual communities like Truckee or Auburn or Sonora, in many cases it's actually windier in the valley than it is in those locations. But remember, it's the canyons and passes that squeeze the wind, make it speed up, dry it out, and that's where the power lines happen to be, and that's why they're shutting off the power. Now, later on this afternoon, the wind will be very consistent in the valley spots, and it'll be a little more hit and miss gusty in the Sierra foothills, but watch what happens by sunset, folks. These are the dangerous times because in the middle of the night, tonight and early tomorrow morning, that's when I think we're going to see some of the strongest winds and wind gusts in the Sierra. Now, remember, this is when the power's out, people are sleeping. Your traditional way of getting information visually is gone. Maybe some of the other electronic ways are at least more difficult or may not be working as planned. So your job is to pay attention to the weather. Pay attention to what you're doing all day long today, because almost all fires are caused by humans in these cases, either accidental or otherwise, so you don't want to be part of that. And number two, you need to be prepared, because we've seen time and time and time again that when the winds ramp up and a fire breaks out with these conditions, it's the middle of the night that people need to evacuate without any warning, and that's when you need to be ready to move. So just think about your situation, those around you that are not in position to help themselves, that need more time, and be able to be ready to move, because the conditions are ripe for fast-moving fires today and early tomorrow morning.
So we got your fire, we got wind, we have heat. Can I ask you before you go about air quality? Is it going to be bad today, and is the wind going to actually help that?
At the moment, it is unhealthy and or hazardous, especially for the Tahoe Basin. I think it's going to go back and forth between moments where it clears out and then the plume of smoke. Kind of depends on where it's going to head from the fires down south. Might be headed to more valley spots, but in general, not great today. And if a new fire breaks out, it's not going to get any better.
Okay, Rob, thank you for all your reporting this morning from your backyard, out in the wind, and you got boards blowing over and a playground.